Being able to recognize and tag people in your photos has been a really helpful feature in iOS over the years. And now with iOS 17, you can tag your pets as well, which means that you can search for a picture of your dog and your mum at the beach together and it will find it for you. It's really clever. If I go onto this photo here of Poppy and Mabel in the woods, and I swipe up to get the information, you might notice in the bottom left corner of that picture, there are two little circles, one for each dog that's been detected. When I tap onto the little circle with Poppy's face in, I have the option to name this pet, and I'm simply going to type in Poppy on this screen. I'll do the same for Mabel as well, I wouldn't want her feeling left out. I'll tap on her little picture, and I'll call that one Mabel. Now, after assigning Mabel her name, it's actually asking me to review some extra photos. These are pictures that it thinks might be of Mabel, but it's not completely sure. And actually, it's like to get me to check, because these are previous Irish Wolfhounds, not Mabel at all. I'm going to unselect them before I move on. But now, if I go back to the album screen, and then scroll down to where the People album lives, it's now called People and Pets, I can tap onto there, and straight away you'll see my three cats are on there already. Now, these albums at the top have been marked as favourites, that's why they're always at the top and they're nice and big. Poppy and Mabel haven't been given that status yet, but I want to do that, obviously. So I'm going to scroll down my list of people until I find Mabel and Poppy, and I'm going to tap the little heart symbol next to their picture. When I go back to the top, I've now got all three cats and both dogs in that album screen at the top. And of course, just like you expect, if I tap onto one of those albums, I then get all the pictures of Poppy, or all the pictures of Mabel, or all the pictures of Polly, everything that my iPhone has found, just like it would do with people. Now, I found this to be pretty reliable. For example, Pudding and Mr. Tibbs both look very similar. Sadly, we lost Mr. Tibbs in January, and we had Pudding in about June time, and the iPhone has recognised that they're two different cats, even though they do look quite similar. So it is a really useful feature to have, and like I said, it makes searching photos even easier. And if you like these videos, please do subscribe down below, that way you won't miss any more iPhone quick tips in the future.